I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. For an increase in faith. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. For increase in hope. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. For an increase in love. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The first sorrowful mystery is the agony in the garden. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The second sorrowful mystery is the scourging at the pillar. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The third sorrowful mystery is the crowning of thorns. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Almighty Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The fourth sorrowful mystery, the carrying of the cross. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Almighty Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The fifth sorrowful mystery is the crucifixion. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those who most need thy mercy. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the reward of eternal life, grant, we beseech thee, that by meditating upon these mysteries of the most holy rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise through the same Christ our Lord. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, most Sacred Heart of Jesus, most Sacred Heart of Jesus, Immaculate Heart of Mary, St. Joseph, St. Martin de Porres, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Good morning. Welcome to St. Martin de Porres. Today, the Church celebrates Christ's entrance into Jerusalem to accomplish the Paschal mystery of his death and resurrection. The gospel, palm cross blessings, and the procession will begin outside. Please remember to silence your electronic devices. On the back page of your bulletin, you will see a reserved seat sign. You may place it on your pew, bring your palm cross, and join us outside. If you're not able to join us outside, please remain seated, and we will be asked to stand once the blessing of the palms take place. In the procession, we'll come down the center aisles, and then you'll recess back to your seats through the two side aisles. God bless. Morning, Jordan. Thank you.
However you're comfortable.
When the gospel comes, I'll take this down.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, since the beginning of then until now, we have begun our hearts by penance and terrible works. Today we gather together to herald
what the whole
Thank you.
As we raise our palm crosses, please join in singing Hosanna, found on page 6, song number 3, pardon me, page 3, song number 6 in your worship aid.
Sing Hosanna, Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who as an example of humility for the human race to follow, cause our Savior to take flesh and submit to the cross, graciously grant that we may heed his lesson of patient suffering and so merit a share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
This moment, may I invite our young friends from first to fifth grades to gather in the center aisle of the church for the dismissal. May the Lord enlighten your minds and your hearts as you go forth, being taught to understand and live the Word of God. Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Open my ears, Lord. Help me to
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord God has given me a well-trained tongue, that I might know how to speak to the weary, a word that will rouse them. Morning after morning, he opens my ear, that I may hear. And I have not rebelled, have not turned back. I gave my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who plucked my beard, my face I did not shield from buffets and spitting. The Lord God is my help, therefore I am not disgraced. I have set my face like flint, knowing that I shall not be put to shame. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
let him rescue him. If he loves him, my God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Christ Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness. And found human in appearance, he humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Christ, King of endless glory.
God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him a name which is above every name. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Today's version of the Passion reading can be found in your missalette, beginning on page 9. The assembly may join the readers in the part of the crowd found in bold throughout the reading. The words are a little bit different than they have been in the past. For those of you unable to remain standing, you may be seated at any time. The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark. The Passover and the Feast of Unleavened Bread were to take place in 2 days' time. So the chief priests and the scribes were seeking a way to arrest him by treachery and put him to death. They said, "Not during the festival, for fear that there may be a riot among the people."
When he was in Bethany reclining at table in the house of Simon the leper, a woman came with an alabaster jar of perfumed oil, costly, genuine spikenard. She broke the jar and poured it on his head. There were some who were indignant.
"Why has there been this waste of perfumed oil? It could have been sold for more than 300 days' wages and the money given to the poor."
They were infuriated with her. Jesus said,
"Let her alone. Why do you make trouble for her? She has done a good thing for me. The poor you will always have with you. And whenever you wish, you can do good to them. But you will not always have me. She has done what she could. She has anticipated anointing my body for burial. Amen, I say to you, wherever the gospel is proclaimed to the whole world, what she has done will be told in memory of her."
Then Judas Iscariot, one of the 12, went off to the chief priest to hand him over to them. When they heard him, they were pleased and promised to pay him money. Then he looked for an opportunity to hand him over.
On the first day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread, when they sacrificed the Passover lamb, his disciples said to him,
"Where do you want us to go and prepare for you to eat the Passover?"
He sent two of his disciples and said to them,
"Go into the city and a man will meet you, carrying a jar of water. Follow him. Wherever he enters, say to the master of the house, 'The teacher says, where is my guest room, where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' Then he will show you a large upper room, furnished and ready. Make preparations for us there."
The disciples then went off, entered the city, and found it just as he had told them. And they prepared the Passover. When it was evening, he came with the 12, and as they reclined at table and were eating, Jesus said,
"Amen, I say to you, one of you will betray me, who is eating with me."
They began to be distressed and say to him, one by one, "Surely it is not I." He said to them,
"One of the 12, the one who dips with me into the dish, for the Son of Man indeed goes, as it is written of him. But woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would be better for that man if he had never been born."
While they were eating, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to them, and said,
"Take it, this is my body."
Then he took a cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them, and they all drank from it. He said to them,
"This is my blood of the covenant, which will be shed for many. Amen, I say to you, I shall not drink again the fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God."
Then, after singing a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. But Jesus said to them,
"All of you will have your faith shaken, as it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be dispersed. But after I have been raised up, I shall go before you to Galilee."
Peter said to him, "Even though all should have their faith shaken, mine will not be." Then Jesus said to him,
"Amen, I say to you, this very night, before the cock crows twice, you will deny me three times."
But he vehemently replied, "Even though I should have to die with you, I will not deny you." And they all spoke similarly. Then they came to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples,
"Sit here while I pray."
He took with him Peter, James, and John, and began to be troubled and distressed. Then he said to them,
"My soul is sorrowful even to death. Remain here and keep watch."
He advanced a little and fell to the ground and prayed that if it were possible, the hour might pass by him. He said,
"Abba, Father, all things are possible to you. Take this cup away from me, but not what I will, but what you will."
When he returned, he found them asleep. He said to Peter,
"Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep watch for 1 hour? Watch and pray that you may not undergo the test. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak."
Withdrawing again, he prayed, saying the same thing. Then he returned once more and found them asleep, for they could not keep their eyes open and did not know what to answer him. He returned a third time and said to them,
"Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? It is enough. The hour has come. Behold, the Son of Man is to be handed over to the sinners. Get up, let us go. See, my betrayer is at hand."
Then, while he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, accompanied by a crowd with swords and clubs, who had come from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. His betrayer had arranged a signal with them, saying, "The man I shall kiss is the one. Arrest him and lead him away securely." He came and immediately went over to him and said, "Rabbi," and he kissed him. At this, they laid hands on him and arrested him. One of the bystanders drew his sword, struck the high priest's servant, and cut off his ear. Jesus said to them in reply,
"Have you come out against a robber with sword and clubs to seize me? Day after day I was with you teaching in the temple area, yet you did not arrest me, but that the scriptures may be fulfilled."
And they all left him and fled. Now a young man followed him, wearing nothing but a linen cloth about his body. They seized him, but he left the cloth behind and ran off naked.
They led Jesus away to the high priest, and all the chief priests and the elders and the scribes came together. Peter followed him at a distance into the high priest's courtyard and was seated with the guards, warming himself at the fire. The chief priest and the entire Sanhedrin kept trying to obtain testimony against Jesus in order to put him to death, but they found none. Many gave false witness against him, but their testimony did not agree. Some took the stand and testified falsely against him, alleging, "We heard him say, I will destroy this temple made with mice, and within 3 days I will build another not made with my hands." Even so, their testimony did not agree. The high priest rose before the assembly and questioned Jesus, saying, "Have you no answer? What are these men testifying against you?" But he was silent and answered nothing. Again, the high priest asked him and said to him, "Are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed One?" Then Jesus answered,
"I am. And you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of the power and coming with the clouds of heaven."
At that, the high priest tore his garments and said, "What further need have we of witnesses? You have heard the blasphemy. What do you think?" They all condemned him as deserving to die. Some began to spit on him. They blindfolded him and struck him and said to him,
"Prophesy."
And the guards greeted him with blows.
While Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the high priest's maids came along. Seeing Peter warming himself, she looked intently at him and said,
"You too were with the Nazarene, Jesus."
But he denied it, saying, "I neither know nor understand what you are talking about." So he went out into the outer court, and then the cock crowed. The maid saw him and began again to say to the bystanders,
This man is one of them.
Once again, he denied it. A little later, the bystanders said to Peter once more,
Surely you are one of them, for you too are a Galilean.
He began to curse and to swear, "I do not know this man about whom you are talking." And immediately a cock crowed a second time. Then Peter remembered the word that Jesus had said to him, "Before the cock crows twice, you will deny me three times." He broke down and wept.
As soon as morning came, the chief priest with the elders and the scribes, that is, the whole Sanhedrin, held a council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate questioned him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" He said to him in reply,
"You say so."
The chief priests accused him of many things. Again, Pilate questioned him, "Have you no answer? See how many things they accuse you of?" Jesus gave him no further answer, so that Pilate was amazed. Now, on the occasion of the feast, he used to release to them one prisoner whom they requested. A man called Barabbas was then in prison, along with the rebels who had committed murder in a rebellion. The crowd came forward and began to ask him to do for them as he was accustomed. Pilate answered, "Do you want me to release you to you, the king of the Jews?" For he knew that it was out of envy that the chief priests had handed him over.
But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them instead. Pilate again said to them in reply, "Then what do you want me to do with the man you call the king of the Jews?" They shouted again,
Crucify him.
Pilate said to them, "Why? What evil has he done?" They only shouted the louder,
Crucify him.
So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas to them, and after he had Jesus scourged, handed him over to be crucified.
The soldiers led him away inside the palace, that is, the praetorium, and assembled the whole cohort. They clothed him in a purple, and weaving a crown of thorns, placed it on him. They began to salute him with,
Hail, King of the Jews!
And kept striking his head with a reed, spitting upon him. They knelt before him in homage, and when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the purple cloak, dressed him in his own clothes, and led him out to crucify him.
They pressed into service a passerby, Simon, a Cyrenian, who was coming in from the country, the father of Alexander and Rufus, to carry his cross. They brought him to the place of Golgotha, which is translated place of the skull. They gave him wine drugged with myrrh, but he did not take it. Then they crucified him and divided his garments by casting lots for them to see what each should take. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews."
With him, they crucified two revolutionaries, one on his right and one on his left. Those passing by reviled him, shaking their heads and saying, "Aha,
you who would destroy the temple and rebuild it in three days, save yourself by coming down from the cross.
Likewise, the chief priests with the scribes mocked him again themselves and said,
He saved others, but cannot save himself. Let the Christ, the King of Israel, come down from the cross, that we may see and believe.
Those who were crucified with him also kept abusing him. At noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. And at 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
"Eloi, Eloi, lema sabachthani,"
which is translated,
my God, why have you forsaken me?"
Some of the bystanders who heard it said,
Look, he is calling Elijah.
One of them ran, soaked a sponge with wine, put it on a reed, and gave it to him to drink, saying, "Wait, let us see if Elijah comes to take him down." Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. The veil of the sanctuary was torn in two from top to bottom. When the centurion who stood facing him saw how he breathed his last and said, "Truly, this man was the Son of God."
There were also women looking on from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene, Mary, the mother of the younger James and Joses, and Salome. These women had followed him when he was in Galilee and ministered to him. There were also many other women who had come up with him to Jerusalem.
When it was already evening, since it was the day of preparation, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a distinguished member of the council, who was himself awaiting the kingdom of God, came and courageously went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Pilate was amazed that he was already dead. He summoned the centurion and asked him if Jesus had already died. And when he learned of it from the centurion, he gave the body to Joseph. Having brought a linen cloth, he took him down, wrapped him in the linen cloth, and laid him in a tomb that had been hewn out of the rock. Then he rolled a stone against the entrance to the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joses, watched where he was laid.
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters in the Lord, true love stories include not only the details about the romance, the affections, and the gifts, but also include details about sufferings, patience, endurance on the part of the lover toward the beloved, so that the beloved not only being persuaded by the glories of love, but also through the suffering, the patience, the pain, the self-giving over, the humility of the lover, the beloved will surely be persuaded by the love of the lover. And then two hearts can be one, and the beloved will follow the lover. Today, Mass, its full name is Palm Sunday of the Lord's Passion. We don't just celebrate Christ's glorious, joyful, noisy, triumphant entrance into the city of Jerusalem, but we also, in the Passion account that we just heard and proclaimed, also go through the story once again of Christ's passion and death. The liturgy put these two seemingly opposing themes to us, not to confuse us, but to present to us that the glory of love and how far love can go to persuade the beloved. In this case, the lover is our Lord Jesus Christ. We think of Palm Sunday as joyful, triumphant, glorious, cheering with the palms. We think of God too at times. We cheer for God. We hold in things, say, yeah, God, go, way to go, God, way to go. But then many of us have not yet been persuaded by the love of God. And because of that, love of God and our heart are not yet united, and our lives have continued on the path that is not of the same love of God. And therefore, the passion that we heard not only once again tell us of what Christ would endure, what we would commemorate on Good Friday, but to one way is to trying to persuade us, see how far love of God can go to persuade us that He truly loves us, that He really wants us. Usually we go to Palm Sunday and we go to Easter Sunday and we miss the middle. And we're wondering why at times I'm not yet being persuaded by God's love for me. It may be perhaps we have not seen once again through the liturgy the sufferings, the pangs, the wounds, the patience, the endurance, and the greatest humility of God to be warned by His love. It is just like a wandering child did not know how much he was loved until he saw the suffering, the pangs, the endurance, and the signs of love shown by a parent or someone who loves him dearly. There was a young boy growing up in an abusive family, and when his father was not around and he was about very, very young, his mother got sick, and because of that he had to receive nutrition from a woman named Mary. Because of life situation, he wasn't able to grow up with this Mary, so he grew up, go on his way, and live a life of, let's say, of pleasures. He throw his life out with the wind. And he was also a good swimmer, but deep down inside, he did not know how much he was loved. So life happened, and one time he returned to his hometown, and for some reason that name Mary came up, so he got to the yellow phone book, many of us still remember. He found Mary and her house, so he came, he asked for Mary. And Mary came, greeted him, all wonderful. And then Mary told him, just wait here for a moment. So Mary came down from the steps with a metal box. She opened it, and in it, it contained all the newspaper reports about how good the swimmer the boy was. He was being followed all those years without knowing that he was that loved. So Holy Week begins. Eventually we come to Easter Sunday, but let us not hurry. My invitation, our invitation for you all, is to participate in the sacred triduum so that through spending time hearing the details of our Lord's last hours on earth, we pray, to be persuaded by God's humility and love that St. Paul say in the second reading. And we pray by being persuaded, our heart and God's love will be united, and therefore we will be won over by God's love, not only in this life, but in the life to come. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the good, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us bring our prayers to the Father. Through the Son he gave up for us, with love beyond our comprehension.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the whole church, united with one heart, as our Savior prepares to meet his painful destiny, that we may follow him faithfully to the end, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the peoples of all races and nations who seek peace, that their search be realized through their Master's redemption, we pray.
Lord,
for all parishioners of St. Martin de Porres, that through grace we may bear our own crosses and be raised with our Lord, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are ill, especially Ryan Mahoney, Catherine Scalise, Melody Gonzalez, Edwin Valdez, Debbie McKeehan, Kevin Porter, Emmy Lopez, Richard Oren, and all of our sick, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased, especially Jose Manuel Lopez Mendez, Elena Mercado, and Priscilla Vija Broza, may they rest in eternal peace with God in heaven, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intention in our book of petitions and those prayers that we hold in our hearts, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also pray in this Mass for the repose of the soul of Rosario Gaudines, for whom this Mass is being offered. Lord, our Father, with serene courage your Son went forth to die for us. Grant us a share in his strength. As we bring these prayers before you, we ask all these through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Please join in singing our offertory song, Your Only Son. Song number 4 on page 2, Your Only Son.
Son, no sin to hide, but you have sent him from your side to walk upon this guilty sod and to become the Lamb of God. Oh, Lamb of God, sweet Lamb of God, I love Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept a sacrifice for the praise and glory of his name, for our good. Through the passion of your only begotten Son, O Lord, may our reconciliation with you be near at hand, so that though we do not merit by our own deeds, yet by this sacrifice made once for all, we may feel already the effects of your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For though innocent, he suffered willingly for sinners and accepted unjust condemnation to save the guilty. His death has washed away our sins, and his resurrection has purchased our justification. And so, with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Sanctus.
Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, Veni sunt celi et terra, gloria tua. Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in
indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we will be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop, Timothy and Tan, his assistant bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Thank you, dear.
Stay, we totally stay, God's abundant.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Please join in singing our first communion song, Were You There? Song number 3 on page 2, Were You There?
Thank you.
Please join singing our second communion song, Hosea. Song number one on page two, Hosea. Join in singing our next communion song, We Adore Your Cross. Song number five on page six, We Adore Your Cross.
Let us pray. Nourished with these sacred gifts, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that just as through the death of your Son, you have brought us to hope for what we believed, so by his resurrection, you may lead us to where you call. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
This week we celebrate the sacred Paschal Triduum, which is one liturgy over 3 days, Holy Thursday, Good Friday, and Easter Vigil on Holy Saturday. During these 3 days, we are called to enter into the time of deeper prayer and worship. Please check the bulletin for the time of our liturgies over this sacred triduum and participate with us. The parish office will be closed at 3 p.m. on Holy Saturday, on Friday, and on Easter Vigil. During this most holy time, St. Martin's will offer an opportunity to meditate on the Shroud of Turin. A full-size replica of this great relic is now displayed in the choir area, as we can see on the left side of the church. Please come and visit. There will be no Saturday confessions or the 5:30 p.m. masses either on Saturday or Sunday next weekend. We ask for your patience on Easter Sunday with many mass times that are displayed in the church bulletin, as we expect large crowds with limited parking. Please join fellow Catholics in visiting 7 churches to adore the Blessed Sacrament on Holy Saturday, following the practice of the early Christian pilgrims. St. Martin's will welcome adorers from area churches throughout the night in our Hall of Repose. Please see the parish website for the churches where we can visit. At the conclusion of these 2 weeks, on Sunday, April 7, we will celebrate the Divine Mercy Sunday with Holy Hour, 3 p.m. in the church. In preparation for the Divine Mercy Sunday, a representative from the ministry will be on the Garing Plaza after all masses. Please stop by to learn more about this powerful and prayerful experience. And as we make our way out, if we see any palms on the ground at the pews, please gather them. They might have been blessed already, so we shouldn't kick them or use them as sword like little kid you always do. But we gather them in baskets, and we have them so that we can have for the next Mass to be used as well. Thank you so much. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
Look, we pray, O Lord, on this your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ did not hesitate to be delivered into the hands of the wicked and submit to the agony of the cross, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. Build him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen.
Yeah. It's great. Okay, I'll just put this right here.
The Sorrowful Mysteries of the Most Holy Rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. For an increase in faith, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy